I join my comrades this morning in welcoming all of you. I want you to be reminded that the strength of whoever oppresses you lies in your weakness. Today, we have decided to shake off those weaknesses and to tell Nigeria and the entire world that this land belongs to us. Israelito! Israelito! Well, the message is simple. It is that their arguments have not shifted from saving cost to improving human capacity to also undermining the efforts of those who are circumventing our economy. But all we have seen are lies and lies and more lies. Do we have electricity today?
No.
Has the stamp duties not been increased?
Yes.
Has the prices of petroleum not been increased?
Yes.
So, instead of what they told us, that we will have more for infrastructure, we have seen it so soon. That is all about transferring the commanding height of our economy to their cronies.
Well, it's always difficult to speak where generals stand, because all of us here are generals of struggles. I only want to remind us that this struggles not going to be a 100-meter dash. It's a marathon against market forces. And when you are doing that, you should not be tired. I've counted here, we have more than 12. Jesus started with 2 disciples. At the end of the day, they increased to 12 disciples. Today, Christians have over 2.2 billion people in the world, united by the ideas of Jesus Christ. What I mean to say is that our idea grows beyond this number and is going to continue spreading because everybody is involved. Lastly, they created what they call market forces. It's a lie. They are the forces, they are also the market. And you can see, the Minister for Finance became corporate affair manager of Dangote Refinery. When he came out to say, Dangote Refinery, at the end of the day, the prices will not make any difference. This is what they get here, they refine here. So for those who are thinking that government should wait, citizens should wait for Dangote Refinery, please, you are going to wait till you die. Great Nigerian people.